Praise King Selassie. This video is tips on how to grow marijuana, cannabis, if you prefer, in states where it's still illegal. First, marijuana will never be illegal. Just like man can never take away another man's right to freedom of speech. We saw that when the martyrs were burned at the stake for professing their faith in the Lord. And although they may have lost their body, they did not lose their souls. These are forms of freedom of speech. Man can only kill the flesh. Genesis 1:26, all the herb of the earth, every herb-bearing seed, which giveth forth the fruit, is given to all mankind. Even these herbs were put on the earth in Genesis 1:11, before man. God, he curses himself. So if you're in a state where people still get locked up, families divided against each other, people basically forced into bondage because they chose plant over poison. You know, of course, some people say, well, you don't need anything. But the same people that say that, the same people that drink pretty heavily. So man is a lie. And if you be one of courage, you must stand up to this lie. Now, in the past, man operated in secret, covertly, to distribute marijuana. Now people say, oh, that's crazy. The scapegoat have been the cartels. Now, you can go to the Iran-Contra and find out that the man was pushing crack cocaine, something that people are given life sentences for. So this is not far-fetched, to say the least. Not to mention, there are court cases that document the dealings of so-called government agencies in the distribution of marijuana. So this is public knowledge. States, they prosecute based on the quantity. So, obviously, having one plant is less. Risk. Now the man operates from intimidation. He claims, say, he's gonna make the herb like alcohol so that it's more convenient just for people to go down the street and buy it from the man. Well, this is very difficult to believe, saying that the herb comes from the seed. Anyone that has property can plant. So the man's game is pure fright. Fear, fear, fear. Make people pay if you don't. There is court cases where the law had been nullified. For example, in the state of New Hampshire, the case of Doug Darrow. Although it is said the federal government has the ultimate authority, try running that by a local judge, because they seem to think otherwise. So, yes, it's a rule of hypocrisy, and it's based on greed, that the only real consideration the man has about marijuana is profit. And the man is looking to prosecute you for profiting off of the substance. So, don't sell it. Keep currency out. If you are taken to trial, and trial is essential because you may become the hero in your hometown. Now, I hope that's not your motivation, but people will love you if you set them free. All people are being subjected to this form of torment. Very mild, nevertheless, form of torment. If you be like myself and your heart rate goes up, you have what some may call cold blood, that's damaging your body. It's unhealthy. And if it happens because you get the helicopter on a regular basis, or police are parked out inside your house, there is a reason. Psychology is a weapon, and it can cause even sometimes more harm than physical harm, because somebody, let's say, gets bombed, they're gone. But if you torture someone in a chamber, the person would rather die. Herb is a sacrificial offering. The herb is good for mankind. Those that do not believe this, do not use the herb. Where are the studies? There are no studies, because it's a Schedule I public. However, in private, there's plenty of studies that have demonstrated the damaging effect that marijuana has to the oppressor.